Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you non-adaptive routing algorithms. In my last video, I have explained you basics of routing algorithms, right? We have discussed about basics of routing algorithms. We have also seen how many categories of routing algorithms are there. In general, two categories are there. One is non-adaptive and second is adaptive. Non-adaptive, that comes under static routing algorithm. And adaptive comes under dynamic routing algorithm, right? And we have seen dynamic parameters of routing. These dynamic parameters that we consider in adaptive algorithms, right? In this video, I'll be explaining you non-adaptive routing algorithms. Those are static in nature. So first of all, you need to understand what is the meaning of non-adaptive routing algorithm. See, here algorithm will not change with respect to situation. Non-adaptive means what? With respect to situation, algorithm should not change. It will remain static. It will be fixed. Here, I'll explain you two categories. One is flooding routing algorithm and second is random walk. I'll explain you both of this by practical examples. Let us try to understand first what is the meaning of flooding. See, in flooding, what we do is we transmit frames to all the possible interfaces. Let me show you by practical example. Like you see here, let us say H1 is forwarding frame to H2, right? So obviously H1 will have to send frame to router 1 over here. Now router 1 will forward it to all possible interfaces. So it will give it to router 2 as well as it will give it to router 5. Now you see router 2 is receiving this frame. It will also forward it to all possible interfaces like this. So router 3 and router 6 both will receive this frame. And you see, router 6 will give frame over here, router 3 will give frame over here, router 5 will give frame over here. So same frame that is received over here at router 4 from three interfaces and it will give it to H2. So here flooding is happening. Flooding means from all the possible interfaces we are transmitting frames. Means here there is a flooding, there will be so many duplicate frames. Right, you see here this router 4 is receiving three copies of same frame. Right. So in flooding, router will be forwarding frames to all possible interfaces. Right. See, in this algorithm, each router forwards incoming frames to their neighbor routers. This method doesn't need any routing table. See, this method doesn't need any routing table. Why? The reason is here, see, this router knows as a frame comes, it will have to forward it to all the routers. It will not have to check even from where it is coming and from or in which direction we need to forward it. So that's why you can say here you don't need to have routing table. You are just forwarding it everywhere, right? See, network congestion, that will be the major issue with this algorithm. Why? The reason is you see single frame that is transmitted over all the links. You can have one path, but here if you observe, there are so many paths, right? Duplication is happening. So unnecessarily, this network is utilized over here. There is a possibility of duplication as well as there can be possibility of infinite loops. So here, network congestion, that is the major issue which is there with this flooding routing algorithm, which is non-adaptive. Here in flooding, what we do is we transmit frames to all possible interfaces. That's why it is referred as flooding, right? See, here, you can say maximum congestion will happen with this algorithm. See, this method gives guaranteed shortest path. Guaranteed shortest path means what? Like you see here, when you forward the frame, it will go via all the possible path. Right? It will go via all the possible paths. So obviously, frame will reaches to destination with shortest path. Right? Out of all the possible paths, one path will be shortest path. Now, shortest path, that is having a meaning. See, shortest path means what? Minimum time to route the frame. So here when we say shortest path, it is not like length of cable or something like that. It means how much time that we take it to have destination, right? So shortest path that we consider over here based on timings, right? So in general, when you forward the frame, transmission plus propagation time that we calculate, right? Transmission time plus propagation time. So based on that, you will have to calculate total transmission plus propagation time. That will be the total time And based on that, you need to understand what is the shortest path, right? See, this method is reliable as frame will reaches the destination. Why it is reliable? The reason is, here it is guaranteed. Even if any link is getting break, frame will reaches to destination via other path, right? So this is reliable method. And you will be observing, it can be used in natural disaster, or we can use it in high priority data transmission. If some data are having very high priority, then that data transmission can be done by flooding, right? Some natural disaster may happen, like tsunami or earthquake. Like for example, in Kutch, Gujarat, once upon a time there was earthquake, and at that time it was possible, like so many buildings have collapsed. So during that, so many breakdown of cable that may have happened. And as if government wants to communicate with each other, then there was no guaranteed path. So they can use flooding mechanism in that situation, right? So this is what practically people were been using in some situations, right? Now let me explain you second method, that is random walk. Now from name itself you can understand, random walk means it will choose path randomly. For example, as if I say here H1 wants to communicate with H2, so H1 will forward frame to router 1. Now router 1 will have to decide in which direction frame should be forwarded over here. It may choose this path or it may choose this path. Let us say it is choosing this path right now. Now frame comes to router 2. Now router 2 will have to take decision whether to go in this direction or this direction. Let us say it is taking this path. Let us say it is taking this path. So now this frame will come to router 6. Now router 6 will forward it to router 4, and router 4 will forward it to H2. See, this is how frame transmission is happening. So obviously here there is a need of routing table, right? But here selection of path, that is happening randomly. Router will take decision randomly over here. That's why it is referred as random walk, right? See, this random walk that people used to study for probability and statistics, right? Practically this method is not implemented. And here we need to understand like what is the probability of routing, and based on that we can understand like how routing can be done. Practically this is not implemented, but to understand how probability is there, we are studying this method, right? Right now I'm not going in that detail like what could be the probability and all those things. The reason is, in network there are so many parameters. So based on parameters also this random walk can be implemented. Like once you understand randomness, then some parameters can be added, and based on parameters you can improve upon with the method of routing, right? See, in this algorithm router will select the next path randomly. This method can be implemented as per weights associated with the neighbors. Like here you see router 1 is connected with router 2 and router 5 over here. So it can check the weights over here. Weights means what? That weights can be there based on priority. Like if I say frame transmission is having higher priority with router 2 compared to router 5, it can be there based on traffic. For example, as if I say router 2 that is connected with some network over here, right? And as if this network is very busy, then weightage may be given to this path. That weightage also can be there based on time delay. So time delay, obviously that is based on transmission time plus propagation time. So there can be weightage. Now that weightage may be there with respect to varieties of parameters, and based on that this random selection can be done, right? Practically that is how it can be implemented. But here we are talking about random walk, means here randomly path will get selected, right? And that randomness can be avoided by considering weights, right? See here, network congestion means duplication of frames, infinite loops, which we have seen it over here with flooding, right? There can be duplication of frames, there can be infinite loops. So here that will not happen, right? Here that will not happen. You can say it will be having very less chances. Nothing is impossible, right? There can be some infinite loops, it is possible, but chances of that will decrease over here with this method. So this method is practically not used in practice. This is what we are studying it for, probabilities and statistics, right? So this is how random walk is there. And this flooding method, that is practically implemented for some special cases like natural disaster or some higher priorities of data are there with governments or some systems, right? In that case, they may use this algorithm. But practically, in general, let me tell you, non-adaptive algorithms that is not used nowadays in 2023. Right now, we are using adaptive algorithms only, and practically link state algorithm that we are using right now, distance vector algorithm that we were been using way back in 1990s, right, with Alpha Network, US defense sector was using that algorithm, and up to early 2000s they were been using this. But right now in this entire globe, adaptive algorithms are used for routing, and in general we can use this link state algorithm, even that is available in practice nowadays. So that is all about non-adaptive algorithms. Now from next video onwards, I'll start with adaptive algorithms. Still, if anything that you like to ask, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.